Right, so you've decided to get to work on Joomla. You've heard all the good news about it. You want to download it and get started. I'm about to take you through the steps you can take if you want to start off by working from your own PC instead of from a remote server. Now, if you're going to be uploading it straight away to a remote server, it most likely will work because the server will include server functionality. However, if you're going to first try it out on your own PC, you may be missing some of that server functionality because Joomla is a database-driven system which needs some Apache and PHP as well as MySQL for everything to work. So the first thing we have to do now is to mimic that functionality by putting it on your own PC at home. And there's some very nifty, quick, and simple solutions that you can use for that, which I'm going to show to you. A magic little functionality which beds down really well with the Joomla front-end files is the USB web server, and I'm going to show you where to get it, and which version to use, and how to install both the web server and your Joomla site files. So let's get started, shall we? First, we are going to go and find the USB web server by way of Google. And Google will take you to their site. And you are going to discover that, yes, the welcome page is in Dutch, but we will go through to the downloads, and you will find there is a version in English as well as in Dutch. Very useful to start by downloading the manual. You never know, you might need it in the future, and that way you've got it. So we'll start by downloading the manual and storing that in the directory where we're going to store everything. So let's create a directory and call it Joomla Tutorial, shall we? And that is where we can leave our manual file. So next we'll go for the zip package of the USB web server itself, and we will download that also and to the same directory. Now make sure you choose the version, the second one, the Engels, Engels meaning English in Dutch, and you'll have the English version. Good, there she goes. So that's the back end taken care of. Once we've got that downloaded and unpacked into our Joomla tutorial directory, of course, or whatever name you've given it for your own site, of course. And the good news is that just like Joomla, it's all absolutely free, no strings attached. So that's looking good. We've got all the files of the USB web server neatly unpacked into our directory where we also had the manual. Not that that's very important, the manual could be anywhere, but this is important, this stays together. And this is also where we are going to be putting our Joomla package when we get that unpacked. So let's go and get it from the Joomla site. Now this zip file we're going to be treating in exactly the same way as we did with the USB web server packages. We're going to be putting it in the same directory, and the Joomla files are going to be one notch deeper into that directory. They have to be placed in the root directory, as we will see presently. But first of all, let's start by getting them downloading, and from then to unpack them, and then we'll look at where we're going to be placing them. So here, notice that I'm not going to put them directly in the Joomla tutorial directory, but I'm going to put them in the subdirectory root. It's very important that all the Joomla files get placed in the subdirectory with the name root. So now it's time to pay attention because we're going to run into some little tricky bits. Nothing to be worried about, nothing we can't handle. The USB web server installation already had an images folder installed, so we're going to accept the Joomla using the same images folder. And we are also going to find that there are two files by the same file name. An index file PHP from the web server installation and one from the Joomla files installation. So for now we'll accept the offer to keep both files. Right, so everything's installed and we're ready to take off. Time for the moment of truth. Now in the Joomla tutorial directory, open the USB web server function and just accept whatever Windows firewall asks you to unblock. And lo and behold, you now have your USB web server running. That's a good start. Everything seems to be working. The Apache's working, the MySQL's working. So just allow it to open the browser when it starts, and you can choose to hide the USB web server at startup, because in practice you won't shouldn't need it too much. There's one other little tip. One thing to watch is the Apache port address. It can come standard with an 80 address, but as Skype quite often likes to use the 80 address, you sometimes need to change that to an 8080 address. So if there's no Skype running and you can use the 80 port, that means you should now be able to open with localhost. Now add administrator to your URL address HTTP localhost. So that's HTTP localhost / administrator. So now you're on the last leg. You're into the Joomla installation settings. So just go through the seven steps listed and follow the Joomla instructions. I always maintain the USB web server settings, including the local host setting, the username root, and the password used most often is USBW. And then for the database name, I just usually keep the name of the website. Well, we're doing fine. Not too long to go now, and we'll be able to get started on the development of our website. So the FTP configuration, if you're working from Windows, you can just pass on this one for now. So time to put in some of the real names and details for the site that you're going to be making. So for the administrator password, just to start off with, I just usually use admin, because that's what it quite often comes with as a default. And it's easy enough and best to change it later when you know you've got everything up and running. So if it's your first installation, it's not a bad idea to install the sample data so that you've got examples of everything, of all the Joomla basics. So now the moment has come to do a few last steps that Joomla requires, and that's to go back into your root directory, find your installation directory, and simply delete the entire installation directory now. So now we should have everything almost up and running. So let's give it a try and see how far we've managed to get. Well, oops, something went wrong. So it looks like what we have here, we have not got the Joomla page open, but we've got a USB web server page open. Now, if you remember, when we installed the Joomla files into the root directory, we had a double occurrence of an index file. And it's now using the index file for the USB web server page instead of for the Joomla page. We're going to have to do something about that. However, in the meantime, what we have got up and running is the Joomla administrator side. So let's take a look. So from the Joomla administrator window, we can click on preview and see what the site looks like. And as we can see, we still have that darned USB web server page, and that's not the one we want. So we're going to change that. So now let's go and do our last little repair job. We're going to go into the root directory. We're going to find the index file from the USB web server, and we're going to find the index file from Joomla. We're going to remember that the first index file was the one from the first download, so from the USB web server. We're going to change its name accordingly. And we're going to take the second index file, that's the index file with a 2 in brackets behind it, and we're going to take simply away the 2 in brackets. Now let's go back to our Joomla administrator screens and back to the preview button and see what happens. And lo and behold, now we have the proper Joomla screen with the sample files. Now, one of the nice things about Joomla is that you can easily change the look and feel. So we'll just go into the templates and I can show you how you choose with the default star which template you would like to use. So now if we go for the Purity one and we look again at the preview, you'll see that you've got a whole new look and feel. And last but not least, while we're there, maybe you'd like to change that Joomla logo and name in the left-hand top corner for your own. So let's go back into the administrator. And within the administrator, we'll go back into the template configuration. And we'll just take away the logo by changing image for text. We'll replace the name Joomla. Go ahead, replace it with the name of your own site. And you can even replace the subtitle if you want. And we're done. So there you go, congratulations. You've done it, you've got Joomla up and running. So now all that's left to do is let the creativity flow and make yourself a wonderful website. Good luck and thanks very much for watching. Bye now.